Many of us at some point wonder how God can let innocent people suffer or even be killed. The Book of Mormon's accounts of persecution and martyrdom can help us find meaningful answers to this sobering question. Abinadi, who was commanded by the Lord to preach repentance unto King Noah and his people, was tortured to death by fire. In another story, over 1,000 anti-Nephi Lehis were slaughtered when they refused to fight against an opposing army. And in perhaps the most tragic account of all, Alma and Amulek were bound and forced to watch women and children being cast into a fire for believing in the gospel. Like so many of us, Amulek asked, "How can we witness this awful scene?" Alma replied that God allows the wicked to act out the desires of their hearts so that the judgments which he shall exercise upon them in his wrath may be just, and so that the blood of the innocent shall stand as a witness against them. If divine intervention were to be the rule instead of the exception, then the agency of mankind would be largely compromised. It is also important to recognize that in each of these stories it is stated or implied that salvation would be given to those who suffered for their beliefs. And in each case, God's purposes were further accomplished through the courageous actions of these martyrs. The Book of Mormon shows that Jesus Christ willingly suffered with us and that through his atonement, he can heal any degree of sorrow and replace it with eternal joy. And now you know why.